For a character who wants to be in charge, yet often gives in to cowardice, who is constantly coddled by his mother, which actually feeds into his paranoia, who encourages a mob mentality with an admittedly catchy song, I really thought that I'd dislike Sprout as a character. He represents so many of the qualities that normally detracts from my enjoyment of a film, and yet, somehow, the MLP staff still makes him funny to watch. And while I don't believe his bigoted attitude towards unicorns and pegasi can keep him entertaining in the long term, there is still a lot of potential with his initial character flaws for the first season or two of the Netflix show. In many ways, Sprout reminds me a lot of Diamond Tiara from the Friendship is Magic series. Spoiled, selfish, always wanting to be in charge so they can have all the glory. In fact, they both have mothers who intentionally or unintentionally taught their offspring bad behavior from an early age. But at least in the case of Phyllis, she is far more understandable and even redeemable in the eyes of the audience. As for Sprout, though, I fully expect the MLP staff are going to continue with his bratty yet cowardly demeanor, all the while being consistently coddled by his mother. Actually, in one of the early concepts for the My Little Pony: A New Generation film, Sprout's fixation on his mother was even more pronounced, as it was considered that his war machine would be in Phyllis's image. Oh my goodness, that would have been really weird to see. Probably was a good idea to tone that back, but you have to admit, it would have been quite the memorable scene. But what exactly does the MLP staff intend for future stories focused on Sprout? Obviously, there's going to be quite the learning process to undo all those years of deep-seated bigotry towards unicorns and pegasi, much like how it took several episodes focused on Diamond Tiara before she was able to put aside her own spoiled nature. Though Sprout will have the advantage of being more likable and entertaining, provided the writing can keep that same tone with his character as what we saw in the film. He can be a consistent source of conflict here and there in the follow-up Netflix series. Especially with how easily he was able to stir up an angry mob, I fully expect that he can continually cause mischief with various forms of misinformation, given his upbringing and how the rest of Maritime Bay has been constantly fed paranoid propaganda for their entire lives, it will be quite the difficult process to undo all that deeply ingrained mistrust. And with such a setup, I have no doubt there will be deeper themes and lessons taught from each episode. Hasbro knows full well from their experiences with Friendship is Magic that My Little Pony has a far greater potential than just for selling toys. And while there will certainly be stories with more simple setups and a black and white resolution, I'm looking forward to the more nuanced conflicts that don't come with such easy answers. While Sprout is an antagonistic character and will very likely continue to be so in the follow-up Netflix series, I think he has some interesting potential, whether as a sidekick to Sheriff Hitch, a manager at Cantor Logic, both with and sometimes without his mother's approval, or maybe even still having followers who believe that nothing good can come from interacting with unicorns and pegasi. But what do each of you think? What were your first impressions of Sprout's antics, and what do you believe lies in the future for his character arc? Leave your thoughts in the comments below, because as always, I am Dr. Wolf, and I look forward to hearing from you.